Right, let's talk about tactical reloads and speed reloads. Now, there is a difference. A tactical reload is not real practical for environments while out on the street. Okay, maybe for home defense or SWAT team applications, they may apply when you think that you need to top off. For the most part, tactical reload is not practical in the real world. Now, we're going to show you two different ways to do a tactical reload, and which one you use is totally personal preference. A lot of schools teach that when you find a lull in the fight, maybe behind cover, concealment, etc., that what you're going to do is grab your spare magazine, bring it up, and then you're going to drop your other magazine. So basically, you're forming an L or a V, however you want to look at it. Rotate the fresh one up and in, and then put the old one in your magazine pouch, okay, and then get back to taking care of business. All right, now the problem with that is that at this moment where I have both magazines in my hand, I'm very vulnerable. If I were to have to move at this point in time, maybe somebody from behind rushes me and grabs me, etc., now I don't have any magazines, okay? I might have one shot left. Not a good game plan, okay? That's not very smart. Now, what we teach is that what you're going to do is economy of motion, okay? We're big believers in that. You are going to drop this mag, put it in your pocket, grab the new one, bring it up and in, okay? And give it a good tap and then get back into the fight. So at any point in time, I only have one magazine in my hand, and that's very important because I'm not going to lose it if I got a good grip on it, okay? But anytime that you have two in your hand, you're trying to juggle that, then there's a potential for that. So that's the tactical reload, right? Not real practical in most real-world encounters. Now, let's talk about the speed reload. The speed reload is basically where your gun goes dry, your slide locks back, and then you have to put bullets in it, okay? So what you do is you let the magazine drop to the ground. Bring your new one up, put it in there, tap it, and then rack your slide forward and get back into the fight. Okay, now, what I want to say is when you're training, okay, what you don't want to do is look down and then bend down and take your eyes off the potential threat area. Everything is training, okay? So what I want to do, I'm going to have you look at my eyes, okay, so that way, you know, I'm not cheating, okay? I'm going to look right at that dummy out of my peripheral vision. I'm going to see the magazine, or I can even look down for just a split second, but I don't want to put my head down. Okay, now I've stepped on the magazine, looking at the potential threat area, and then picked the magazine up and put it in my pouch. Okay, so empty magazines go on the ground, bottom line. All right, so anytime you're doing anything, make it training, okay? Don't be vulnerable at any point in time in your training is what I'm saying, okay? Gun during the tactical reload or speed reload stays between you and the target, okay? So that way you can do all your manipulations right here where you can see the potential threat area, okay? So that's the tactical reload and the speed reload. As always, train hard, train often, and most of all, train realistically.